everyone. Welcome to another exciting edition of Happy Foods 242. Is the girl Sash Laurel. We off the street right before you get to portion control, and we're at Cassava Grill. It's pretty much a new eatery, so we're gonna show you what all they have to offer in terms of food and drinks. Stay tuned, you're watching Happy Foods 242.
Excuse me, sir, does the sofa come in black as well?
I'm sorry, miss. I don't work here at Donald's Furniture.
I know that, but you work for BahamasLocal.com and you pretty much know everything about the Bahamas.
Yeah.
Excuse me. Do you guys sell security cameras as well?
I'm sorry, ma'am. I don't work for the Armory Company.
But you work at BahamasLocal.com. You guys know where everything is in the Bahamas.
We might not know everything, but we do know how to get your business more business.
Hey, Mr. Bahamas Local. You think government gonna do this new national insurance tax or what?
Contact BahamasLocal.com.
All right, so welcome back. Happy Foods 242. We're at Cassava Grill. Still a relatively new business. We're here with the owner, Chef Owen Bain. And Chef is going to tell us a little bit about his story. Chef, how did you even come up with this idea to open your own restaurant? And give us, if you can, the story behind the name itself, Cassava Grill.
Okay, very well. Two very interesting questions. Mm-hmm. Well, the first concept came from, I guess, my friends and I and my parents. Mm-hmm. Our quest for good food, you know. I traveled the world extensively. I started my career here locally. Working through the hotels, I worked in probably all of the hotels here in the Bahamas.
Okay.
Then I went to New York and I traveled and I worked at, I went to school at the Culinary Institute of America. And then from there, I went to Italy. And from Italy, I went to Jamaica, I went to Antigua, I went to St. Lucia.
Just everywhere.
Just everywhere.
Okay.
During this time, when I started my career, a lot of the questions were saying Bahamian chefs don't have enough international experience.
Mm-hmm.
So I wanted to break that myth and get the most international experience I can get, and then come home and actually serve my country.
Okay.
So coming back home, 2008, mm-hmm. During the Olympics, they caused quite a stir with the cassava, with Usain Bolt.
Usain Bolt, right.
So you know, I really started to think about it. Hey, mm-hmm. What's up with this cassava? So we paired the cassava with a little bit of a cooking technique that's done here locally a lot using the grill, mm-hmm. and we came up with the baby cassava grill. And here we have it. One thing about Cassava Grill, we're organically Bahamian, which means everything that we serve here comes either from a local farm here in Nassau or throughout the Commonwealth of the Bahamas.
Awesome.
We totally believe in local farmers and local products. I've traveled the world extensively and I think the Bahamian product is one of the best in the world.
Okay.
So everything that you'll be featuring here today, you'll be featuring the restaurant, definitely comes locally from the Bahamas, from the farm.
Now tell us a little bit about these cassava chips.
Yes.
I get the menu every day. My good Soro is your sister.
Yes.
She sent me the menu and this is a staple on the menu. You can get these cassava chips.
Yes.
But they don't taste like cassava. Is there a secret?
There is a secret. There's a little secret, and of course, you know, we can't disclose the secret.
Okay.
However, I want you to know that they're all local and we do create our own seasonings.
Okay.
So everything you taste here is actually packaged and seasoned and done only and exclusively at Cassava Grill.
Only and exclusively?
Okay. Yes, ma'am. So,
Chef, this is not a talking show.
Yes.
We need to get some important details.
Definitely.
Just tell us where you're located,
uh-huh.
your number, all your social media pages, how people can find you, that sort of thing.
Okay. Well, great. Well, our number here at Cassava Grill is 601-5171. Relocated on East Street. If you're heading north, just before you get the Super Value,
okay.
We're in a rust color, I guess.
Orangish.
Yeah. Plaza,
you know,
right?
Us Spanish,
yeah.
We ain't gonna give you the exact
color.
Orangish.
Orangish, salmonish. You know, right next to Super Value. And if you hit Super Value before, if you hit the light of Super Value, you're actually past us. But you can actually see us on the road. We're the first restaurant as you turn inside on your left hand side.
Now, by this show, by the time the show would have aired, you would have already started serving breakfast.
Yes.
So just give us some insight on some of the things you would have started doing, because the show is pre-recorded.
Oh, definitely. So. Well, one of the things that we will be doing for breakfast is we'll be turning the whole grits plus concept on its head. You know, we'll be serving 100% corn grits that's done here in Hocklands, here in the Bahamas.
Wow.
So you'll have a choice of either yellow grits or peas and grits.
Mm-hmm.
But we won't be
peas and grits.
Oh yes.
These people ain't go to work. Peas and grits.
Definitely peas and
with
grits
with your regular tuna.
Okay. Well, I wouldn't say regular tuna. If you're gonna serve tuna here at the restaurant, it'll be our fresh tuna steaks, and we'll be asking you how you want it for order. So you can have it either rare, medium rare, well done. It all depends on how you want it.
Okay.
We also have instead of corned beef, we have our local Long Island wild hog. Pulled pork. It's gonna be nice.
So not that stuff out of the can.
No, the only thing we have in cans here at the restaurant are beans and tomatoes. That's it. Yeah. That's it, nothing else.
Okay.
Nothing else. We don't live in a can. We cook here at the restaurant. We will also be featuring our pepper bacon as well, which we do.
We make our own bacon.
All
right. So you're open Monday to Friday?
Monday to Saturday.
Monday to Saturday.
7 a.m. to 6 p.m. Right now, okay. For this week, we'll be serving from 12 to 6 lunch. Mm-hmm. But in the following week, we'll be open from 7 to 6.
7 to 6.
7 a.m. Monday to Saturday. Yeah.
Any plans for expansion? I know you're still relatively new, but I try to give our viewers that insight, the things that they can't hear anywhere else.
Well, definitely.
Is there another Cassava Grill maybe in the west and the east and the... Okay.
You're trying to give out all the secrets.
Okay, got you.
Well, yes, it is our plan to expand. Mm-hmm. However, this will be our home
staple.
Base. Our home base and our staple. We actually had the opportunity to do it out west and out east, but we decided to do it here, closer to the local community, closer to the urban community, so people can actually begin to understand the process of where their food comes from. Mm-hmm. You know, food doesn't come out of the food store. It actually comes from a farm. And then it travels and it goes to your food store. So we actually want to build that relationship with our community first, with our community and our local farmers and local fishermen, and bring the community together, and then we begin to outstretch our arms.
Okay, well, that's enough talking. Plenty talking, in fact. When we come back, y'all are going to see us in the kitchen cooking up some chef specialties.
Definitely.
This is Happy Foods 242.
So this is sofa come in black as well?
I'm sorry, miss. I don't work here at Donald's Furniture.
I know that, but you work for BahamasLocal.com and you pretty much know everything about the Bahamas.
Yeah.
Excuse me. Do you guys sell security cameras as well?
I'm sorry, ma'am. I don't work for the armory company.
But you work at BahamasLocal.com. You guys know where everything is in the Bahamas.
We might not know everything, but we do know how to get your business more business.
Hey, Mr. Bahamas Local. You think government going to do this new national insurance tax or what?
Contact BahamasLocal.com.
Okay, welcome back, everyone. We're still at Cassava Grill, and we are now in the kitchen. I'm very, very excited. And Chef Owen is doing something behind me, so I'm just going to get a little closer to him. He is doing what you call a chicken chop up.
Yes.
Now, Chef Owen, I noticed the chop ups on the menus that I get. What is a chop up?
A chop up. A chop up is basically a deboned chicken leg. We debone it here at the restaurant. We use all the bones and we make chicken stock for our soups and sauces. And it's stuffed either with a vegetable stuffing or whatever we have locally. We've stuffed it with grouper, we've stuffed it with lobster, we've stuffed it with Cajun shrimp, one of our favorite dishes here.
Okay.
And this is served on a bed of jasmine rice with native stewed beans.
Okay.
And also with a little curry, you only remember the one with the chips?
Oh, right.
Yes.
Okay.
That's served with our dishes every
so
single day.
So we're stuffing it with what today?
Today we're going to stuff with our lobster stuffing. Okay. So first, like you said, you get your chicken, chicken legs, and it's deboned.
I see you lightly salted it.
Oh yes, we lightly salted it.
Now this isn't that regular stuff.
This comes raked and scraped right from Long Island. We actually put a little bit of our
bay leaf.
Oh, not bay leaf. What do we call here at the restaurant? Our seasoning.
Okay.
This is a spice leaf plant that comes up a little taller.
Okay.
You may know it as all spice plant.
All spice plant.
Allspice plant
now,
leaves on the inside.
Tell us why you put that in the salt. Does it keep it fresh?
Well, it does. Well, one thing salt does, the salt removes all the moisture out of them so they're nice and dry as they cook in our food. And it also, throughout the pulling process, it infuses the salt. So our salt has a nice spice flavor to it when we season anything in the restaurant.
Okay.
Yes.
All right.
And then this is our secret magical, wonderful mixture of mixes. Come on, you can smell, you can guess what's in there. That's what we season our chips with on the
table. Okay, that's what's coming. That's what on the chips.
Yes.
Now, you can tell us what in it, like, give us two of the ingredients.
Sugar and salt.
Sugar and salt.
Excellent. Great.
And you can tell us anything else.
Of course. I'll give you a little more insight afterwards.
Okay.
So you also want to sprinkle it lightly over your chicken as well. You want to be very seasoned. Here at Cassava Grill, we have a theme. Kill them with flavor. Everything you have, we want you to go home and say, what's that in your teeth?
Right.
You a little taste?
That's what I know with that.
Definitely.
Guacamole right now.
Excellent. So here
is this is the lobster stuffing?
Yeah, lobster stuffing. We make all our stuffing, we put them in piping bags, so it helps the process go a little bit easier.
Okay.
We usually work, like most things in life, we read left to right. So we also fill left to right.
Okay.
So you want to make sure to get down into the bone, because at the bone is where it caps it off.
Okay.
You just want to get a nice fit on the inside in there.
Squeeze that boy.
Oh, look at that. That's called love. That's love right there. It's a little bit of lobster love for you. Okay. So then what we do next is, oh, please get a nice shot of these wonderful, wonderful
red onions.
Oh, yes. These are from Grille Farms. It's a local farm right here, right up on South Beach.
Okay.
Farm. Yeah, definitely.
Providing us with those.
Oh, yeah, they are. Lobster stuck on the inside.
Okay.
So, as you can see, it's a nice healthy portion of lobster on the inside. So, you're not getting
robbed
or cheated. Right. So, you can get a nice full portion. What we're going to do is we're going to roll it over slightly. Okay. Bring it in tighter, bring it in tighter, bring it in tighter. And then, hey, whoop.
I just want to get it back in.
There you go.
Good job. We don't waste on this show.
Definitely. No wastage.
No wastage.
We use two methods here at the restaurant for time. This one is a quick and short message, underhand message, overhand and under. Wow. Set tight.
Okay.
There
you go. Now our grill, which is behind us, is already at what temperature?
We usually keep the grill at around 275 to 300 degrees. Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. When we do our pulled pork, we do it at 250 degrees for 14 hours.
200. Okay. Just say that part again, so my view is 200.
Yes, 250 degrees
Fahrenheit for 14 hours.
14 hours. You cook it low and slow, so it peels right off the pork.
And
very, 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 very tender. You know, it's a long ad hoc, so it's actually been running around in the fields for a long time. So they're very strong. Their bones and their joints and the muscles.
So does that mean the meat is really tough?
The meat is really tough initially, but as it breaks down, it has a tremendous amount of flavor because it doesn't eat like from a farm, like a particular corn. People taste that they have, it's almost a spicy, more gamey taste that you'll have from the wild hog. Because they're allowed to roam freely and eat whatever they like.
Gotcha.
So there we have our lobster chop up. And this will be transported right over here into our grill.
So we already have one done there.
Oh yes, definitely. Yeah, that one done, and that's basically the process.
Okay.
And I'll put that one on a plate. And you guys can actually try it and have a wonderful meal.
So that takes how long to?
Oh, here we cook it on the grill on both sides, 8 minutes each side, and we come back about 15 minutes. You'll get a nice and golden grill marks on the top of it.
This
is one that's already being done for you.
Look at the juice.
You see the juice coming out of it live, you know. Definitely. So you're gonna use our scissors. Kind of free them from their bondage. Oh, the juices are still there. You see that? Oh, that's nice. Just going to cut this a little bit more. And then we can slice.
Wow. And it just
oozing with flavor.
Wow.
Oozing the meat. Nice lobster coming through on the top.
I really have no words. So
Well, you know, definitely. Well, we're going to put it on the plate.
Okay.
We're going to have you try some of it.
So when we come back, you'll see Chef plate this. We'll do a few other items. And then I have to get some of that sea grass.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Yeah. Definitely.
I don't want to give you all the secrets, but we have some drinks that they do as well that are awesome. Stay tuned. You're watching Happy Food. Hey everyone, it's your girl Sasha Laurel, and if you want to be on Happy Foods 242, you can. All you have to do is find us on Facebook, find us on Instagram, or find us on Twitter. The hashtags for all of them, the ads for all of them, Happy Foods 242. If you want to get in direct contact with us, though, you can email us. We have a Gmail account. That's happyfoodsbahamas@gmail.com. You can also reach me on my personal Instagram, @SashaLaurel. Just send me a note, send me a direct message, and I'll be sure to message you. Remember, at Happy Foods 242, food is the source of life. Welcome back. We're still on Happy Foods 242. We're still with Chef Ben. What we're going to do is show you all the food at the end so that we can show you everything together. So Chef has some lovely products right here in front of me. Chef, you could just take it away and I could just...
Great. Right. Well, what do we have here? We have two varieties of fish that we use here at Cassava Grill. Mm-hmm. They're both grouper. This is our grouper cakes. And as you can see, I just brushed it with a little bit of egg wash. You see the nice pieces of grouper on the inside? Is groupery a word?
Groupery, it could be a word today. You heard it first.
Yeah, groupery, you heard it first. Okay. And then over here, we have our Benny crusted, locally Benny crusted grouper fillet.
And when I think of Benny, I think of Benny cake. I think of sweet.
Yeah, well, but this is actually savory. This is not sweet, this is savory. Okay. But it has a very rich and a very nutty flavor that goes along great with the grouper because it's nice and buttery. So we're gonna do, I'm gonna do a little bit of the cakes. I'm gonna have you go over here and actually make your very own, very first and own, Benny.
My Benny crusted grouper.
Your Benny crusted grouper finger.
Gotcha.
Let me see, check your finger. Is that, yeah, excellent.
Okay, perfect.
Okay, well, with this process of the Benny, what we would do first is, first you would dip in the flour, then egg, and then we're going to crust it.
So my fish goes in the flour first.
Yep.
Now, chef.
Yes, ma'am.
I know you ain't really been telling me much about the ingredients, but this ain't white robin and flour.
No.
Something in here.
Well, there's a little bit of our secret here. It's mixed with a little bit of smoked paprika and a little bit of our seasoning that we use for our chips.
Okay.
And it's also not flour that you will remember as AP flour or all-purpose flour. It's cassava flour. Actually, we get it imported. This is cassava flour, so it's 100% naturally gluten-free.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
And then, so I go in my egg mixture.
Yeah, it's going to go in your egg mixture.
This egg or this something
no,
else?
No, no, egg, no gluten, no, okay. No, just egg, just egg.
Just egg,
just
yeah,
regular,
just egg.
Regular organic
eggs. I have
eggs.
Got some, because everything
just regular organic
some
eggs. That have been locally grown here in the Bahamas.
Okay.
And then you want to dip it in some Benny. Now you want to get, make sure you want to get a nice press on it. So you
now, where the Benny comes from, Andres? Or?
Yes, but the Benny does have a...
I know something,
yeah,
you know.
You are on top of things.
I know something I can do on the show this season.
So with our Benny, we get it in fresh and we patch it. You know, when you patch your Benny, you got to patch it good. So we cook it a little while just to release the nuttiness and those nice oils that comes from it. Oh, wow. You've done this before.
Well, you know, I've been said to be a culinary expert.
Excellent. I'm just going to go
I know my mommy like rolling her eyes like, really, Sasha? Really? I don't need to cook when my mommy cooking, you know? That's how I feel.
You put the rest of it on your plate.
Okay.
Awesome.
Now mine's look, why y'all don't look flat and then mine's look like...
Well, we want to make sure you give it a little press.
Okay. Don't press mine too much.
Oh, okay.
I do want mine to look different.
They look different, of course.
Okay.
And then we have our cakes.
Okay.
Our group of cakes. So once again, a little bit of egg wash.
I'll just let
and then
you
flour.
That part.
Yes. Now the reason we want to do a little bit of egg wash and flour because it kind of protects it.
Okay.
And we don't want it to be too bready. We want to actually taste the grouper in there.
Right.
So it's a very light.
It almost
light
looks
flavor.
Like a really big comfort.
A big comfort. close, definitely.
Okay.
So you just want to bind it.
I'll get another so I can help you out.
Oh, wonderful. You just want to coat it very lightly. And then when you cook it up, you'll see it's very soft, very light. It feels like it's almost going to break up in your hands.
Okay.
But it cooks very
well. Now, the
very
egg wash that you put over it, that's
yes.
to
well,
keep it together?
Yes, the egg wash actually binds it. And the protein in it allows it to give it a better shape and a better shine quality once you put it inside that nice fryer. You use a combination of corn oil and peanut oil.
Okay, so not your regular Wesson. Not your regular Wesson.
Yes, ma'am, you can, definitely.
I feel like I'm a freak kid. Now, how hot is your oil in there, chef?
My oil is now about 365 degrees temperature.
Okay.
So it's going to right now. You want to make sure the process is really timed. And I always tell my staff, you want it mango skin, you know, nice and light brown. Get too dark, no, it's a problem.
Why it can't be melanin skin?
It could be melanin skin, but then I mean I'll overcook my grouper, and I don't
right.
want that to happen. It's all about the food. Here at Cassava Grill, it's all about the food.
Gotcha.
Oh, nice.
The mine's is flour.
Yeah,
that's fine. I like to season it.
You like to season it. I understand. That's wonderful. And we'll make sure this comes out excellent.
Okay, so in the interim, while those are frying.
And what we can do, we're actually going to plate one real quick.
Okay.
We also have here in-house made fresh pickles that we make it on a daily basis.
Pickles ain't Bahamian.
Pickles ain't Bahamian?
No.
No? Oh, you should try some of it. You tell me.
I mean, I'm not saying that it's not good. I'm saying it's not Bahamian.
Oh, okay. Well, we brought a little bit from our Haitian brothers and sisters.
Okay. Nothing wrong with that. It could be all.
Okay.
No,
this
should
be
say
bang a line.
Bang a line. Okay, there you go. Bang a line.
Oh, these two could be for me since you already played them together. Oh, everybody else.
Okay, that's fine.
Yeah, that's one.
That's one. Excellent.
Because maybe you can say we can do our fish. Put our chicken jumbo. So chef, our fish is done.
Yes.
That takes roughly
about 4 to 6 minutes. Four to six minutes.
Now my question is, because it's coated,
yes,
how do we know that it's finished? Well, like the inside is properly cooked, because we don't want to end up serving anybody.
No, we definitely don't want that. And we also, the reason we coat it is we want to protect the integrity of the fish.
Right.
One thing about it, once it's done, we'll see they start to float on the inside.
Okay.
The fish are very intelligent. Once they're done, they start to float, so you know,
okay,
it's ready. And then secondly, you know, you could always take a little peek on the inside, you know, and see the nice juices.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, you
can
get a cool. Okay, gotcha,
yeah.
Gotcha.
That's love.
Okay.
Love. You're gonna take a couple of pieces out.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Make sure nice and done, nice and moist.
Mm-hmm.
That's what we're looking for, the nice
fat. Chef,
yes.
Whenever I go to places,
yes,
one of the things I hate is being served tilapia.
I can't
stand that fish. So can you assure the viewers when they come here, they're gonna get grouper?
Yes, and here at Cassava Grill, all the fish that we serve here is 100% Bahamian. Whether it be hogfish, whether it be grouper, whether it be marbled fish, whether it be snapper, whether it be fresh tuna. Anything that we serve here, and we speak on, we give you that absolute truth in menu.
Okay.
Okay, so when we say grouper, we
it's
serve grouper.
Okay.
Yes, definitely.
Gotcha. So much. Y'all know I like the dots. It just feels so good. All right, so let me try it.
There you go. How is that? Oh, so, I didn't want to interrupt. Is there like a flavor explosion going on right now?
Mm-hmm.
You're trying to understand it, where is it coming from, where you're at, just trying to get some sense of place here in the Bahamas.
Mm-hmm. There's so many things happening with this taco. I'm not really a fan of tacos, but this has like, it takes you around the world.
Definitely.
You kind of get your India, you get a little bit of your Caribbean flair, definitely the Bahamian flair with the grouper and the benny. The sauces, everything just, I at first I was a little bit skeptical because I was like, all these things. You know, when you take all of the goodness and you put it together in one goodness, you're supposed to, sometimes you don't get good goodness, but like this is really good.
Excellent. Okay.
On the show, we say bang a line.
Bang a line, definitely.
Yeah,
bang
right.
A line. Well, here at Cassava Grill, we say
really,
taste
really,
life.
This is really good. What'd you say?
Taste life.
Taste life.
Taste life, yes.
Who is now going to make us a jerk chicken with plantain wrap?
Yes.
And in my hand, at the same time, I have a pink grass with pineapple drink and a
ginger lemonade
with mint. Now, talk to me a little bit about the drinks, because I think the drinks get as much publicity
as
the food does.
I think more, and it's really a battle. The drinks are all homemade. We use 100% local ingredients, local Bahamian ingredients. So like, just last week we had Mango Madness. We were doing the mango drinks very well.
It's one of a whole lot.
They sold very well. And the fever grass, you know, we steep fever grass on a daily basis. We cook it for 20 minutes just to bring it up to the heat, and then we let it steam overnight. And then we use to make our drinks. But the one with the pineapple, what we do is we actually get the fresh pineapples, cut away the skins, and we actually boil the skins along with a few glasses of pineapple.
As you can see, we have everything a chef would prepare, say, for these nice little, we didn't go through this, but he put it there.
Yes, definitely. These are our carrot muffins. My grandmother's special recipe.
So you definitely
can't. I can't tell you that. My grandmother's recipe, you know. She swore me
to secrecy. Okay, so chef, just remind our viewers what all we made today.
Okay, what we made today is we have the Benny crusted grouper, and we have it in our tacos here. We have a jerk chicken and plantain wraps. Egg and pasta.
Yeah.
Okay.
As a steak one.
It's actually served with fever grass and basil. Dressing. Here is our lobster chop up. So lobster chop up here. We have our grouper cakes and of course our cassava chips.
Awesome. Now everyone always says sashi, you say the same thing all the time. The food here is really good.
Uh-huh.
What I like about it is too that you prepare everything fresh daily.
Yes, we prepare everything.
And I'm sure that that's fair. And then you use fresh products every day.
Every single day.
And I'm sure that that's very expensive to do. Because I know fresh products usually cost a lot more, but it's beneficial when the food tastes as good as it is.
Yeah, well, definitely one of the things we want to do is get really creative with the offers that we have locally. Like I say, personally, being a chef, I think the Bahamian product is one of the best in the world. And this is just a small tasting of what can be done in the Bahamian cuisine. So I invite everybody to come by Cassava Grill and taste life.
And just tell us for the last time, chef, where are you located?
Uh-huh.
What time are you open? What's your number? And give us all your social media information.
Okay. Well, once again, we're located on East Street. If you're heading north on East Street, you're right before Portion Control in the orangey, what do we call it? Rust color.
Burnt
to orange. Okay, the burnt orange.
Right before you get to Portion Control.
Yeah, right before you get to Portion Control. So on your left is the first restaurant on your left. And you can follow us on at Cassava Grill on Facebook, on Instagram. You can hashtag us at TasteLife or WeBelieve242. And you get all the information. The phone number here is 601-5171. And we're open from Monday to Saturday from 7 a.m. to 6 p.m. starting next week. But this week we'll be serving lunch.
It'll be open from 7 a.m. to 6 p.m.
Monday to Saturday.
Well, you heard it here first on Happy Foods 242. I am so excited about Cassava Grill and all that it has to offer. The food is really good, it's really flavorful, and I like that it's not just your typical Bahamian food, it also has...
But it is Bahamian,
it has an infusion of a little bit of Africa, a little bit of India, a little bit of Caribbean, West Indian. You kind of get the entire world right on one plate, and I like that. And so the only thing left for me to say is that, chef, you've done an awesome job.
Thank you.
None of this is going to waste. You could just call back. And all of this we will take care of.
Awesome.
We don't waste. Y'all know we don't waste on this show. We're going to eat all of this. I thank you so much. This has been awesome. Make sure you guys come out with the Cassava Grill, East Street, right before you get Portion Control. If you're heading north, you can't miss it. Monday to Saturday, 7 a.m. to 6 p.m. Chef, tell them what show you want.
I'm on Happy Foods 242.